the beginning of the game, only a few cities are displayed on the chart. You can discover other cities by approaching them with a convoy. The city symbol itself gives an indication of the city's size. It also shows the commodity the city currently needs most. Special events in the city are also displayed on the chart. You can view all of the information by opening the city information. It belongs to the dockyard building, which you already know from the trade window. Even if you cannot enter a city because you have neither warehouse nor convoy there, you can still open the city information from the marine chart. The city information tells you everything you need to know about a city. The most important factors are nation, population, the commodities producible in the city, and the city type. The latter indicates whether the city is a simple colonial city or home to a governor or viceroy of that nation. This has implications for the city's size, its defense, and its demands for commodities. The reputation that you have with the city's nation has the following effect. If your reputation is less than 25%, the nation will view you as an enemy. That will happen, for example, if you attack their convoys. Then you should be wary of their military convoys. As you've already determined, four nations are represented in the Caribbean: Spain, England, France, and Holland. Your reputation with each of these four nations will always be shown here. Also shown here is the current relationship of the nations to one another. A nation can either be neutral to all other nations, at war with, or allied to another nation. Relationships between nations are not irrelevant for you. However, they will only play a role when you act for or against a nation and have acquired a letter of marque against a different nation from a viceroy. All that is important at the start is ensuring your reputation in a nation does not fall below 25%, and that the military convoys of nations at war are constantly fighting one another. You can enhance your reputation in a nation only by accepting and fulfilling assignments for an administrator, governor, or viceroy of that nation. These assignments are offered in the city palace, but you need a certain rank to accept them. One more thing about the chart. Each maritime area is associated with a particular power. You can turn the display of this political information on or off at any time. The flag and its intensity shows you which power has the greatest fighting strength here. Normally, cities and maritime regions belong to the same nation, as that nation's military convoys will be patrolling the area. Things become interesting when the city and the maritime region belong to different nations, because then the city might just come under attack.
Thank you. Thank you. It sounded like a simple, easy trip to New Orleans, conducting a young woman to a diplomatic meeting. Yet, she does not like the fact that she has to travel with commoners to remain undetected. And she is also unhappy as she suspects the real reason for her meeting with the French viceroy is simply a chance for him to present his son. The young captain notices her anger and tries to cheer her up, at first in vain, but eventually she laughs, and her radiant eyes burn themselves into his soul. But then she thinks of her mission, and the fact that it is unseemly for a woman of her station to give a common sailor any more attention than is absolutely necessary. And yet, that moment is all it takes for a young man to fall in love with a young woman. Young man tormented by the thought of Elena being forever out of his reach. Even if their paths were to cross again at some point, why should she give him more than a passing glance? After all, he is just a nobody. His chain of thought is interrupted by an excited discussion between two captains at the next table. The viceroy is looking for an aide for his commercial attaché, Pedro de Vega, to further promote the prosperity and wealth of the Spanish cities and the colonies. It must be fate. If he held the post of aide, he could prove himself to Elena. But it will not be easy to convince the viceroy. He painstakingly prepares himself for a perfect audience. With his friend's help, he is granted an audience. At first, the viceroy pays him but little attention, and Elena finds it impudent of this young captain to consider himself capable of such a responsible position. But Pedro de Vega's persuasive arguments lead the viceroy to take a closer look. He sees the determination burning in the young man's eyes. Finally, he nods.
Single ships are of little use, because they have neither a captain nor crew. You can only actively use a ship after you have either converted it into a convoy or added it to an existing one. To add a ship to an existing... You are sure to have noticed this area of the HUD.